its own children. Of all the planets visible to the unaided eyes of the ancients, Saturn is the slowest, which could explain why it's named after the god of lead.
Now Neil strolls among the grassy ruins.
But there's no denying that the more negative aspects of Saturn's personality reflect the age-old knowledge of the symptoms of lead poisoning. Funny thing about the Romans, even though they knew that contact with lead inevitably poisoned people, rendered them sterile, and drove them mad, what metal did they use to make the pipes that carry the water through their legendary aqueducts? I'll give you a hint. The word plumbing comes from the Latin word for lead, plumbum.
Now, a few dilapidated statues stand beneath arched columns, partially edging a rectangular man-made pond. The remains of a villa grace the water's opposite end. Neil walks along the edge.
What metal did they use to line their famous baths? And how did they sweeten their wines when they were too sour? What did they use to line their vats and cooking pots? There's some historians who believe that the widespread use of lead was a major cause in the decline and fall of the Roman Empire. Why did they continue to use lead long after they knew it was toxic?
He takes a narrow path across the water.
It was cheap, very malleable, easy to work with, and the ones who were exposed to it at its most lethal levels, the miners and workers who processed the lead, were considered expendable. Their lives didn't matter. They were slaves. Most of the Earth's lead started off at a safe distance from living things, down below the surface. But about 8,500 years ago, humans began figuring out how to dig into the earth and extract metals from rock. By the time this villa was new, just a couple thousand years ago, the Romans were producing 80,000 tons of lead a year.
Now we drift over enzymes of a human cell.
Why is lead so poisonous to us? Because when it gets into our bodies, lead mimics other metals like zinc and iron, the ones our cells actually need to grow and flourish.
The enzyme of a cell embraces a lead particle.
Enzymes in the cell are fooled by the lead's masquerade, and they begin to dance. But it's a dance of death, because the lead is an imposter that can't fulfill the cell's vital needs.
The cell begins to die.
Lead also blocks neurotransmitters, the communication network between the cells.
A particle gets caught between neurotransmitters.
It interferes with the molecular receptors that are vital to memory and learning. This is especially damaging to children, but lead poisoning spares no one.
Stock footage plays.
Starting at the turn of the 20th century, the makers of leaded paint hired the fledgling advertising industry to persuade the consumer that lead was child-friendly.
A little toy lead soldier once to the Dutch boy said, "We have some fine relations who all contain some lead. Why don't you give a party so folks can meet and see the other happy members of the great lead family?" The first one at the party was Gay Electric Light. He said, "I'm very brilliant. I always shine at night. No little of my brilliance is due to my glass head, which gives a light much brighter because it's made with lead." A pair of rubbers entered and took the Dutch boy's arm. They said, "We are protectors who keep you dry and warm. You know, when we were molded, the man who made us said, 'We're strong and tough and lively because in us there's lead.'"
Stock footage plays.
But lead production didn't really shift into high gear until the early 1920s, when chemist Thomas Midgley and inventor Charles Kettering of General Motors found that tetraethyl lead could be marketed as an anti-knock additive to gasoline.
A line of workers passed barrels through a warehouse.
They formed a new company called the Ethyl Corporation.
Now on board the ship.
It had once been considered for use as a poison gas by the U.S. War Department. Unlike the lead in paint, tetraethyl lead was fat soluble. A half a cup of it on your skin could kill you. The manufacturers calculated that they could sell 60 million tons of it a year.
Headlines appear.
Only problem was some of the workers who processed the stuff in factories in Delaware and New Jersey were going insane, hallucinating, jumping out of windows. They died screaming.
An animated man plummets.
This was a selling job that would require a lot more than dancing light bulbs.
In animation, a worker bursts out of a factory. The crazed man.